If you start with mobile robots, you always need a camera. For object recognition, and also it could be a depth camera for get depth information, where you can see where is the target you like to reach, how far is it, and so on. And on the mobile robotics, you get now quite a big market compared to some years ago from depth cameras. The revolution started with the first Kinect. It was the first one cheap 3D camera you can get. It needed 12 volts, but it was damn cheap compared to other products which costs thousands and thousands, and this one was only 100 euros. So yeah, there was a big place. Big revolution. ROS rised also with the Kinect. There were some unofficial Linux drivers with libfreenect, and there are many projects using this. The Euler from Microsoft forbids the usage of the camera for this if it is easily. Yeah, if you can easily see it's Kinect, so you got somehow to hide the front and then you are allowed to use it. But yeah, that was the start of the robotic revolution in 3D vision sensors. The successor, the Kinect 2, was not that big success because it was first more expensive, and also there are big problems with the USB connection for this one, as long as I know. So, and it's quite energy hungry. You get bigger 2D sensor, but they also changed the technology from pattern generation. They used a ToF camera, time of flight camera, and all, yeah, which needed a longer time to run to get a stable image and so on. So this one is not often used compared to the Kinect 1, but it's also used. You also needed some bigger adapters for the power side, special one which was also quite expensive compared to the Kinect 1, and whole unit was, yeah, it's always the money. If the students do not get enough money to buy something, it will be not a success. So then Intel started with the RealSense technology. This is the, I think it's the F300 for outdoor usage. Yeah, it's Intel started into the market. I like it. One thing I dislike about Intel is that they discontinued the Edison boards. And yeah, if I use a sensor on a mobile robot, I'd like to use it for many years. And if Intel discontinued these products because they are consumer products, then you do not get repair parts. Yeah, this is in a 150 to 200 price range, so it's a little bit more expensive than the Kinect, but I think it's the same price as for the Kinect for Windows. Yeah, usable, it's small, it needs less power compared to the Kinects. It uses a USB 3 connector, micro USB 3 connector. Yeah, they try to sell it with a bundle with an up board. I run some test code but did not get enough time to test it in depth, but yeah, I think it's quite good. Then we got here a successor. It's the F, it's the D415. camera with a Fred mount and also some metric mount on the back. I just receive it, and I think I make a small benchmark all of these cameras, try to compare them. And now let's go to the last camera you can I have and you can get on the market. It's the PMD Picoflex. PMD recommend this one for IR applications and so on, but with this size you can easily integrate it somewhere. You also need the micro USB 3 connector. On this one it was in where is it? Yeah. You need a USB-C connector. It's quite handy because there are some threads, and let's see if the guy. But oh no. So Intel thought to make something good and supplied you with a threadable mount, but the cable. Which threadable mount for the USB cable, but they did not manage to include one. Let's see if there are some printable parts also to get it mounted and somehow yeah, because this was a big problem for the micro USB 3 connector. So they easily react with some power loss on vibrations, and because the USB-C goes deeper, it gets better contacts. And I think USB-C should be better, but let's see. Let's see which camera is the best for your robot. I will try to get some code working for Ross and will report you. Look at here, small. Size comparison of all four cameras, which are quite cheap. So the connects are quite same. The Kinect 2 is quite heavy. This is really light and thin, so for a small robot quite usable. This is for the bigger players. It's quite, has the double of the size. And maybe this is, yeah, it's heavier. This is also quite small. I think the stereo base should be the same. Yeah. So I will make some code for Ross and report you how this thing works. Stay tuned, like and subscribe. More mobile robotics videos will follow.